Good morning, church. My name is Taylor Beleza, and I am in the sixth grade at Tidewater Adventist Academy. Today's scripture is 2 Corinthians 9, 6-8. But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So let each one give as he proposes in his heart, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you always have a sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good work. Happy Sabbath.
Amen. Thank you, Taylor. I love that she almost started reciting John 3:16 by heart, didn't she? She almost started saying, "For God so loved the world." That's awesome, because that shows me that it's in her heart. And you would be surprised at the stories that you would hear of kids that are going to our school, are experiencing Christ at home, at school, and here at church. And the nucleus that's come, Virginia Beach Seventh-day Adventist Church, being a light for the community. This message is tied into that. It might not seem to tie directly to Christmas, but I hope by the end that you'll see why we celebrate this time of year and why we honor our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. When I was thinking about this verse, I was telling Joe Lowe about this van pool that I coordinate. There's a group of four of us that we drive all the way to Fort Eustis from the parking lot. You can almost throw a stone at it here, all the way to Fort Eustis, 1 hour one way each day. And sometimes you just get worn out by it because it just seems like no one appreciates it as being the coordinator. I'm doing all the work and no one appreciates the effort I'm doing. Well, just this last week, one of the people in my van pool gave me a Christmas card. And in that Christmas card was a gift card for $50. And I said, "No, I can't accept this." And he said, "Yes, you can. I'm not going to take it back." Because he said, "I decided a long time ago that I was going to do this for you." Here I was thinking, nobody appreciates what I do. No one cares about the level of effort I take to make sure everybody gets here safely from point A to point B. And he said, "I decided a long time ago that I was going to do this for you. Every man according as he had purpose in his heart, so let him give not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver."
Amen.
We serve a great God. He purposed in his heart at the very beginning a plan for our salvation. How great is our God. During this musical celebration of Christ's birth, I will read biblical selections. Every story has a beginning. The story of Christ begins at the very beginning of time. In the Gospel of John, we read, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that was made." We serve a great God. In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus." In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
With the baby inside.
While they were in Bethlehem, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. Unto us a son is given, unto us a child is born this day in the city of David, the Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Therefore, the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. He shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
Child is this?
Joseph to accept this child. He knew it was not his biologically. He undoubtedly also knew that accepting this child would mean to be rejected by society. But an angel appeared to him and told him it was true, and he believed. So here he was, becoming a father to a child who had no earthly father, accepting responsibility that could ruin his reputation. Clearly, Joseph understood who this child was, and was willing to stake his future on the conviction that this is no ordinary child. Go to sleep, my son. This manger for your bed. You have a long road before you. Rest your weary head. Can you feel the weight of your glory? Do you this world can wait for one more moment? Go and sleep in peace. I believe the glory of heaven is lying in my arms tonight. Lord, I ask that you
my kids. listen to our violence. Bid our hungry souls be filled. We're now breaking heaven's silence. Welcome to our world. Welcome to our world. Right, your fingers sent to heal us. Tender breath prepared for fall. Tiny heart whose blood will save us. Unto us is born. Unto us is born.
Healthy. He was perfect. He was God.